I have a question, but if I could say one thing real quick. Charlie, you've mentioned the Branch Davidians were white supremacists.
So they were classified by certain people as a misinterpretation of Christian theology for being white supremacists, but they were categorized mostly as a terrorist organization by what they were doing in
Waco. I think you're mixing that with Ruby Ridge.
I'm sorry, what?
You're mixing it with Ruby Ridge, which is the same period.
I'm sorry, you have to talk slower.
You're mixing it up with Ruby Ridge, which was the same period.
I could be.
Because the Branch Davidians were like Filipino and white. And
I'm talking about the individuals in Waco, Texas, where the FBI categorized them as a terrorist organization.
My question's not about that, so I guess.
Okay, fine.
But that's not.
We can amend that later on.
Yeah. Charlie, you have come out pretty strong on the side of, you know, Israel and Trump and his recognition of the Golan Heights.
Yes.
This was a week after a company called Genie Energy was granted exclusive mineral rights to the Golan Heights. On their board are Charles Kushner, Dick Cheney, Mary Landrieu, Jacob Rothschild, Larry Summers, and Rupert Murdoch, both left and right names. They both stand to make billions of dollars off that recognition. How much of the U.S.'s policy of bipartisan Zionism is simply political corruption?
Can I ask you a question?
Shoot.
When did Israel take back the Golan Heights? Do you know the history of it?
It was never theirs. They didn't take it back. They invaded it.
I'm sorry, what?
Take back? They invaded it.
Okay. So there's you do know that there are synagogues dating back to 2,800 years ago in Golan Heights, which would by definition be a Jewish religious convening place, right?
There's a mosque in Jerusalem. That's irrelevant.
It was built on top of a temple.
Yeah, it was built on top of the holy site of the temple that King David built. But that's.
No, I'm sorry, I'm just
but I do have a question. Do you realize that Islam was formed in year 600, more or less, yeah. and Judaism's 3,000 years old, and Israel is critical to the Jewish faith? That you agree with that, right?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, okay. So the Golan Heights, you have 2,800-year-old synagogues, and that would be reclamation of the land. But anyway, the history of it says I'll update you on it.
Anywhere there's a synagogue is Jewish land? You're 100% on that.
It's the restoration of Judea and Samaria, which is very, very, very well outlined in the Torah. Let me build it up.
Wait,
for
no,
you.
The Torah.
Judea and
right?
Samaria. Yeah, the Torah. That's the book the Jews study and revere as their holy
they
book.
They hate Samaritans, I thought.
I'm sorry,
like,
what?
They really hate Samaritans.
So, yeah, Judea,
I don't think they should get, like, the Druze who live there.
Judea and Samaria. So, if I can build it out for you if you'd like. So in Golan Heights, northeast Israel, it was right after the Six-Day War when six different Arab countries decided to invade Israel on their most holy day, on the day of Yom Kippur at 2:00 in the afternoon. Syria, Lebanon, Egypt, Jordan, and a coalition of other Arab countries together decided to hit Israel when they were most vulnerable. And so what did Israel do? They pushed back for geopolitical reasons, past Capernaum, past the Sea of Galilee, into what is now called the Golan Heights, where it has always been Jewish land. That has been Jewish land for 2,800 years. This idea of British colonial Syria, that's a made-up country. That is Jewish land, and it always has been. And the idea of Israel is that, first and foremost, there are 41 Muslim-majority countries in the world. Why can't the Jews have one? Why can't the Jews have a single country that they can call home? Two. Jerusalem and Israel mentioned over 450 times in the Holy Book of the Torah. 450 times. In Jewish history, Israel is more than just a place. It is critical to their religion. It is critical to their practice. And arguably, it is the most impactful tradition that has built Western civilization. If you look at the great thinkers of the Enlightenment, many of them drew inspiration from the Torah. So yes, the reclamation of the Golan Heights, no, it was not for some mineral deal that you're haphazardly putting it back. It is the reclamation of rightfully earned Jewish land that was stolen from them by the Syrians many, many years ago.
How many of your... So you're a pretty big Zionist, right?
I'm sorry?
You're a pretty big Zionist, you would consider yourself?
I am a proud Zionist and a Christian and a capitalist and a conservative. We can go on endlessly.
Absolutely, of course. But, like, so you also consider you're an American nationalist, right? American guy.
Yeah. I'm a proud American patriot, yes.
So... Like if there are in LSU, there are Native American burial mounds that are 5,000 years old. Is this Native American territory? Have we violated? I mean, they probably had books. They probably named their mounds a million times. Should we leave right now? Because I mean, it's their land.
Well, you should be asking yourself that question.
I don't live here. I came here to ask you this.
I think you're asking.
I don't live here. I came here to ask you this.
What? Well, but that question is for yourself. You're posing the question. What are you doing here?
I know. I came here. To ask you questions, what I'm doing.
So you plan on leaving the country?
I plan on leaving. Yes.
Look, was the you do plan on leaving?
I mean, at some point, yeah.
What country are you moving to?
Probably France.
Do you think France is a better country than America?
I'm going on vacation. I'm not like living there. Christ.
Oh, okay. Do you think there's ever been a better country than America to exist?
Like cosmically? Yeah, maybe. But like, how do you objectively evaluate countries?
How about generosity, benevolence, productivity, entrepreneurial capacity?
I mean, yeah, Luxembourg's got a higher median income, Sweden, Britain, higher median income. That's a pretty good measurement that we're behind in. So okay. Yeah, there are better countries than us.
So you would say that the European...
Have you ever been to Sweden? I was just in Sweden, and there is an absolutely crippling amount of political correctness where people are absolutely afraid to say anything. I mean, say absolutely anything.
Yeah, that's an objective measure, right? If we're going by the measure of median income, though, it's better. Because there's no, like,
better country. I could go endlessly on why America is the greatest country ever to exist, but here's the funny thing. I bet you won't leave. Because America's the only country in the world that even those who say they hate it refuse to leave.
I don't hate this country. I've never said I hate this country, ever. When did I say that? When?
Well, so you love America?
Yeah.
And you want to move to France?
Why not? Yeah, it's a cool country.
Like, which question? Him endlessly rambling is not a question.
What? You said I hate America, asshole. I didn't say that.
Okay.
Wait.
All right, well.
Do you believe that?
I think what? We start
Do you believe that?
Do I believe that I don't hate America? I don't hate America.
Okay, good luck in France. Au revoir, mon ami. Thank you.
Okay.
Oh, sorry, it's all good.